Alright guys, Count Stank is back at you again today, and in front of you is a really cool box, I hope, I'm pretty sure it is, from the man himself, my good buddy, and a member of the Collector's Talk crew, T-Biz, sent me this, I want to say probably 2 weeks ago, didn't open it because of Halloween. You guys know I was all into my home haunt that I do every year, so I was mixed up in that, so it's finally time to open this thing up, see what he sent me. Without showing his address. That would not be good. Bad. Alright, so. Oh, yes. Ooh, dude. What did he send me? Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Dude. What did you send me, man? Holy crap. What did you... T-Biz has hooked me up pretty royally. Alright, so first up, what he sent me, I'm really blown away, T. T-Biz sent me these, those three of them are the Grenadier figures that were very popular, and they still are, but got big in the late 70s and through the 80s with Dungeons & Dragons, playing fantasy games. So you bought these very, very, very detailed figures, and then you painted them. So it looks like, maybe, I don't know if he painted them, that'd be pretty cool if he did. But I remember him talking about that he had some from when he was a kid. I don't know if these are his childhood Grenadier figures. I don't know. But damn, man, I'm really, really stoked. I had to put some earthquake putty on the bottom of this guy so he wouldn't fall over. But here you go, guys. A little skeleton warrior. The shield. Like, was that a snake on his head? That's awesome, dude. And... it's like a little knife, a little small sword. You can see his straps, a sheath there for a sword. It's like another sword on the side there. Is that maybe that's a dagger, huh? That's awesome, man. I appreciate that a lot, dude. So there's the first figure. And then this guy doesn't stand. Maybe he was meant to go on the horse. I don't know. Maybe. Well, he doesn't go on. Well, here, let me get... this looks like it's a warrior. Fine. Come on, focus. There he is. Again, got some paint on him. Looks pretty cool. Really awesome. Bitch and axe. Yeah, I miss the good old days of the 80s when we used to play D&D. Yeah, and all the stuff was there. Very cool, man. And this horse is awesome. Yeah, these figures have a lot of good detail for the size they are. It's amazing. Makes you think about a lot of the toys out there when people complain about detail and paint app, and here you get these Grenadier figures that are so small and an amazing amount of detail. So yeah, I was trying to put him on. I don't think he's gonna go on. I'm not gonna force him. So yeah, I don't think that he does belong with that. And then he sent me this small plastic little warrior dude that I don't know what this is from. To you at the chime in, or maybe someone can chime in the description down, or I'm sorry, in the comments down below. But very, very cool detail, little plastic, like maybe Conan the Barbarian type warrior dude as well. But very, very cool. So there's that. Let's check out the other thing that he sent me. That's right. T sent me the Captain Rex figure from the TV show, the Rebels, Star Wars Rebels. So I'm really happy to have this figure. I was really happy to see him in the Rebels. I thought it was really awesome that he crossed over. You know, he's an old man now, but still badass, and bring him into the more of the Star Wars world that more of us know. Who's more of us? The guys my age, I guess, that like more of the classic Star Wars world over the episodes 1, 2, and 3, Clone Wars and all that. But great figure. I'm very thrilled to have this guy. Man, I appreciate it, T. I like his outfit. Still rocking the clone trooper armor. There's his helmet. Very cool. Here it says Captain Rex. And on the back, you guys know usually there's a bio. It says, a veteran of the Clone Wars and still formidable warrior despite age acceleration. Rex avoided Order 66 by removing the programming chip. Chip would have turned him against the Jedi. So that's really cool. And of course, he comes with some gizmo gadget. And then this is from the wave with Finn and Unkar Plutt. can't talk. So anyway, really, really cool, man. Thanks a lot, man. So you definitely hooked me up, and the D&D figures will go with the rest of my D&D collection. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this unboxing. Really cool box from T-Biz, man. Again, I appreciate it. Can't say it enough. The great Star Wars figure and some great D&D figures. Yeah, man, that's really cool. So, as always, guys, don't stop collecting and have a great day.
Come on, you don't need the remote to the TV. Put down the TV, watch YouTube, come on!